For the CEOs of major companies worth the millions of dollars they're paid, with Duke Energy asking for yet another rate increase, questions are being raised about how much Duke Energy executives are paid.
And tonight, News 4's Tim Waller is looking out for you with a list of who is making what and how it impacts your electric bill.
Well, many customers, Nigel and Gabrielle, are unaware of the fact that a small percentage of the proposed rate increase actually helps pay for executive salaries. Now, Duke Energy insists it is a very small percentage, and the amount has been cut in half in their latest negotiations with the Public Service Commission. But some of the people we talked to say any amount is too much when customers are being asked to pay more for electricity.
They're the largest public utility in the country, with 7.2 million customers. Duke Energy is the source of electrical and gas power to people in six states, which helped generate a profit of $1.7 billion last year. For the most part, Duke Energy executives get paid for how well the utility's stock performs.
$8.7 million per year.
To the average person,
it's unbelievable.
It seems like a lot.
$8.7 million, $3.1 million, $28.7 million.
Especially as Duke Energy requests another rate increase.
They don't need to go up. They're doing fine.
Consider the earnings of now former CEO Jim Rogers, who was a top boss until July 1st of this year. He was paid purely in Duke Energy stock, which in 2012 amounted to $8.7 million. The number two person at Duke Energy, Chief Financial Officer Lynn Good, received a salary and stock options worth $3.1 million. Good has now replaced Rogers as the CEO and is expected to make around $8 million a year. Even lower level executives fared well in 2012, receiving salaries and stock options worth $2 and $3 million, more money than most people earn in a lifetime.
You feel like you're paying for those salaries?
Yes, I do, and I have for a long time.
But are salaries like these that unusual?
These CEOs are the equivalent of the professional athletes.
Charles Reback teaches finance and economics at USC Upstate's College of Business. He says while it's easy to vilify executives who make millions of dollars, their paychecks are based on how well the company performs and whether shareholders are seeing a good return.
So when we say Duke Energy shareholders, we're not talking about customers.
No, not necessarily.
We're talking about the investors.
The investors. The mutual funds, the pension funds that own stock in Duke Energy.
Last year, soon after the merger between Duke Energy and Progress Energy, Duke Energy stock rose 26%. Revenue increased 70%. The CEO of Progress, who became the odd man out in this merger, received $44 million for his troubles. But what does any of this have to do with Duke Energy's request to raise rates another 16%?
It seems a little inappropriate when you have people struggling, when you have working class people, you know, working hard just to make ends meet, to have the company then award, you know, CEOs $9 million a year or give sweetheart deals to the CEO of Progress for $44 million. It kind of you know, kicks sand in the wound.
Seth Powell of the Greenville County Taxpayers Association says he's in favor of CEOs making all they can, even if it's millions of dollars. But Powell says Duke Energy isn't like other corporations where consumers are given a choice. He says Duke Energy is a public utility that's regulated by states for a reason.
So when you come to me and you say, we don't have enough money, we need more money, it seems to me you're misallocating your money.
And these retired people, a lot of them, are having to decide, do they keep the power on?
The proposed increase in power rates has created plenty of opposition.
Some members of my church are saying that if these rate increases continue, they're going to burn candles and just not use electricity.
But Duke Energy insists the increase is necessary to pay for new power plants that have already been built. Part of the CEO's job, spelled out in the company's 2013 proxy statement, is to make sure rate increases are brought about.
So they have to perform, they have to meet certain criteria before that's awarded, before it's all awarded.
Financial planner Mike Miller agrees the CEO of Duke Energy makes a lot of money. But Miller says other utility chiefs make about the same, some even more, and says it's a job with unbelievable pressure.
Oh, yeah. I don't think any of us would want their job. Although, most of us would say, I'll take the job for 1 year, then you can fire me, then I'll be fine. Because I don't need to make any more for the rest of my life.
But as Duke Energy customers are faced with higher bills, some wonder if these sky-high salaries are worth it.
You know, if you paid somebody half as much, could they do just as good a job?
It's unbelievable. And it's very sad. They should be ashamed of themselves, actually.
Tom Williams with Duke Energy's corporate office in Charlotte says this issue of executive pay often comes up during rate cases. But he says his salaries are determined by a third party and they're designed to attract good candidates. And he says even if they're granted that full 16% increase, electric rates, he says, in South Carolina will remain far below the national average.
Mm. Now, Tim, apart from the salaries, we also learned this week that Duke Energy tried to pass on the cost of political contributions it made to consumers.
And that was in North Carolina, where Duke Energy is also seeking a rate increase. That the amount added up to $326,000. Duke Energy blamed that on an accounting error and says the money has since been removed from their rate hike request.